Hello, my lovely friends, and welcome to my home in sunny London. And this week's edition of our program is dealing with leeches again. And today we're talking about Esmeralda, the big buffalo leech. I'm going to have Chris show her to us.
Here she comes.
This is Esmeralda, and her Latin name is Hirudinaria
Manilliensis.
Manilliensis.
Which is literally the Manila leech, because the type specimen was found in near Manila in the Philippines. And it's the second largest leech in the world. The largest, of course, is the giant Amazonian leech. But this one is found in Southeast Asia. They are bred in places like Thailand and Malaysia. And they use a lot in Ayurvedic medicine for all kinds of conditions.
Lift this plate up, Chris. So I just want to show her to you. Earlier, we tried doing therapy on Chris's neck with Esmeralda, and we couldn't get her to bite. My theory is that she's too full. She's been eating recently in the past month, so that's why she's not hungry. What he says is that it may be because it's too cold here or because it's too bright. As you know, we are in sunny London, so it is bright out here.
Yes. And they are very nocturnal animals. They're not very active during the day, but they are active at night.
So they're nocturnal. And you said that this specimen is prevalent in Southeast Asia?
Yes, that's
and
right.
And they breed them in Thailand?
Yes, and Malaysia. And they're called buffalo leeches because they live naturally on water buffaloes.
They live on water buffaloes?
That's right, in nature.
You mean they live on them?
Yes.
Or do they attach on them?
They attach to them, yes.
They attach to them, but do they live in the lakes?
They live in lakes, yes. Muddy rivers and so forth.
One thing I wanted to point out to you is that this leech, I mean, you can see the skin of it. It seems kind of rough, but it's actually very, very delicate. It's not like the Hirudo medicinalis that are very muscular leeches. This particular leech is a very delicate sort of creature. It doesn't really at all have anything to do with the Hirudo medicinalis variety. And due to her delicateness, it's extremely difficult to take care of her. She has to be kept in 25 degree temperature at all times.
It's essentially the same kind of range of temperature as tropical fish. It's not difficult, but I think they like a stable temperature, and it should be warm. So you want a heater and a thermostat.
So you always want to have a heater to maintain her temperature, as well as you want to feed her every month or so. Or every 3 months, depending on when she or he would get hungry. By the way, leeches are hermaphrodites, so they do reproduce sexually, though, not asexually, which means that they will pair with another leech. They will then perform.
They decide between each other which is going to be the male and which is the female.
That's fascinating.
How they decide, I don't know.
Yes. So they do the mating, and then they will have a cocoon. The female will give birth to a cocoon.
Yeah.
In about a month or 2 months' time.
Yes, and that will be in mud or in the roots of aquatic plants on the riverbank.
That would be in the mud.
Yes.
Or in the aquatic plants.
Yes.
And then the little cocoon, well, it's probably not very little, probably about this big, will then be stuck in the mud for about...
I don't know how long, but a couple of months, something like that, yes.
And then the small leeches will start coming out of the cocoon as soon as the conditions are right.
Yeah.
So, again, this is a difficult leech to take care of, in my opinion. In Chris's opinion, it's not. It's actually, he says, very easy, but he's only had to take care of one. I've had to take care of about 20.
Yes, yeah.
And I found it very challenging. The Heruda medicinalis leeches are, as you know from my other videos, about this small, and they do is require water changing every once a week. This one requires changing of the water not even once a week. It's probably you only dump out the dirty portion of her water and she will stay in an aquarium with filter.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yes, yeah.
So
you probably could keep her in a bowl as long as the temperature was fairly steady wherever it was.
As long as the temperature's steady, we can keep her in a...
You can keep her in a bowl or a large container of some kind. It's just a matter of whether or not the temperature's steady and warm. But I like to keep them in an aquarium with a heater and a filter. With a filter, it means you don't have to change the water so often.
So a filter is essential if you don't want to change the water so often.
Yes,
buffalo leeches.
That's right, or any leeches.
And this is an exotic species. You'll find it on leeches.com, but it is quite expensive. As you know, it's not found here in Europe. It's not found in America. America doesn't even have any blood-sucking species of leeches to speak of, except for one kind that I know of, and that's the North American leech. And they don't use that one for therapy at all. This one is used in Ayurvedic medicine.
Yes.
To what kind of cure conditions? What kind of conditions does it cure?
All sorts of conditions. I know it has been used to cure things like baldness and migraine headaches and things like that. That's just off the top of my head, as it were. But all kinds of conditions. Varicose veins, lots of different things.
Varicose veins, baldness.
Yeah. Yes, yeah.
So Ayurvedic physicians would use the buffalo leeches, not the Heruda medicinalis, obviously because it's more prevalent.
Yeah,
in that part of the world.
They could use European leeches if they're available to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the same purposes.
So Chris, thank you very much for being here and giving us this wonderful presentation of buffalo leeches. We hope to have you again next week.
Yes.
And for all of you out there, thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and check out my links below. And give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. And I'll see you again next week from me, Tseti, and from Chris. Bye!